So there's the downtown Sheraton, and there's Eau Claire, the south side of the Eau Claire Market, soon to be demolished. And just pan around. This is a Cadillac Fairview property here. I'm not sure what it's called. And that'd be the heart of downtown that way. Chinatown's over there. So I'm just gonna kind of walk through here while I still can and take a little bit of footage of Eau Claire before they tear it down. I'm not exactly sure when the exact date is for demolition, sometime in June if I recall, but I think it's still open. Some of the businesses in there might still be functioning, but I want to walk all the way around, though I suppose I could have gone through inside. I don't have too many memories here. I mean, back when it first opened, I remember there was an IMAX theater here. Maybe there was two. And I remember seeing an IMAX movie, Fires of Kuwait and the Rainforests of the Amazon. And I don't think the IMAX theaters lasted too long. Around that same time, I saw Mrs. Doubtfire here. My father took me to the movies for my birthday. That must have been back in the mid-90s. I think this was opened 1993-ish, 94. I do remember the old bus barns that used to be here and the warehouses. And initially, the city had planned to use the old bus barns and warehouse properties and convert that into a market, much like Granville Island in Vancouver. But that never really, not sure why they abandoned that idea, but they built this. And today it looks so tacky and out of date. It has that typical 90s. Even our C-Train stations look like this. So now I'm on the north side of Eau Claire Market. And from what I understand, these properties, I forget what this property is called, River Run Apartments or something like that. They're also slated for demolition. From what I understand, the city bought this property, bought the tenants out. And that's coming down too. And apparently there's going to be an LRT station for the Green Line somewhere here. Not sure if it's going to be above ground or underground. I've heard conflicting, you know, stories on that. And if you go on YouTube, there's a Calgary Transit C-Train Green Line video from 2017. This should be pulled down because half of what you see in that video is does not reflect reality. They've changed the plan so many times since that upload. Still nice to watch. These apartments over here are quite nice. So it'll be nice if they try to revitalize this, and even if they build the LRT station, if they put some commercial space here, maybe some restaurants. I'm gonna kind of explore back here. There's quite a few units here. They have a nice courtyard in there. Yeah, River Run it's called. And the little thoroughfare, pedestrian little park and water park and all that is long gone. And I just thought I would come down here and document a bit of this, because pretty soon that's going to be gone. And that looks like a giant LRT station. I am not sorry to see it go. People rave about her. They bitch and rant about how we tear down things. That's something that I'm proud to see demolished. It's definitely not part of my history. I never liked it. And I knew it was going to be dated. It's just like amoeba carpet of the 90s. The minute they built this, I could tell that it would look dated. Just, you know, thinking too far out of the box at that time in terms of design. But I guess it was a trend. A lot of the hospitals that were built, and not just Calgary. other cities as well. And I'm sure we modeled ourselves after other cities. I will go for a walk through there. And actually on this side here, this used to be the Hard Rock Cafe. It was either here or where these buildings were, was the Hard Rock. Let's see if these stairs are open. The walking room, the running room. Yeah, look at these colors. Wouldn't even help if they painted it. They're so tacky. Looks like a giant kiddie land or playground or LRT station. Surprised the city didn't convert it into another homeless shelter. That wouldn't have surprised me. I'm sure the property values over there would come down, and over there. Yeah, turquoise green, teal green. Teal, I guess that would be. And there's the River Run Apartments. Coming down as well. I can get a decent shot from here. That might be the new gate, pedestrian gate to get into that part, or maybe that'll be the entrance to the LRT. Seems to be a massive curb there, like a garden they're putting up or something. I really don't know. And if the LRT comes through here, is it going to go diagonally this way or straight across the river? Well, maybe it's going to go through that way. It's a mystery. I did check the Calgary Transit website. There is some information, but not a whole lot. Time to update that 7 or 8 year old video, I would say. But I don't think they want to do that because they'll probably change the plans 10 times between now and completion, whenever that is. I'm sure I'll be living in a retirement home by that time. Or 6 feet under. Yeah, I'm going to take a walk around the property. I can cut through those apartments and get to Princess Island Park. Prince's Island Park. Somebody mentioned that on the Facebook group the other day. I think many of us pronounce it Princess Island Park. I have for over 40 years. Until someone corrected me, it's Prince's Island Park. All right, we're gonna go down these stairs. Let's go for a walk inside. Again with the green. Okay, I'll just follow you through. And what's the name of the band? I'm sorry, I forgot.
Ghost Keeper.
Ghost Keeper, okay.
Ghost Keeper, yeah.
Cool. We'll keep a lookout for the video.
Thanks, yeah.
Thank you.
There's a bunch of stuff out right now. This will be our breakfast.
Cool. Good talking to you. Take care. Yeah. Ghost Keeper is the band. They're shooting a video. And that lady, these people here are in the band, production staff, and that lady up there is an actress and the sound person here. Nice. Subway is still open. So there are a few businesses still here. That's cool. I might come here for lunch. Okay. Jackie's Thai. Okay. I'm just going to cruise through to the other door. There's a bicycle shop. Oh, electric vehicles. Everything else is closed. Island Foods is gone. Wow. Barber shop. Probably by appointment only, by the looks of it. We are closed. We will be closed. Gift shop. Escalators are still running. I think I'll go up on the escalator. Dental center. So that would have been the offices when I was on the mezzanine above. That would have been the windows up there. And there's kind of more of the same over here. Everything closed. Wow. So many little businesses. Washrooms and security. Entrance. Perfect place to shoot a movie or a video. Yeah. I'm going to take the escalator up. The old theaters. And I'd mentioned the last time I saw a movie here would have been when there was an IMAX, and I think there was two IMAX theaters. No, maybe not. You know what? I saw Anchorman here, now that I think of it, one summer day. I think I was just pedaling my bike. I did. I came and saw Will Ferrell Anchorman, which whenever that was, 20 plus years ago. Looks like we got some roof leaks. These people are with the band, Canadian Blood Services. I won't bother to walk through there. And I had been in this place, the garage, several times back in the day. I don't want to be too invasive, I'll just walk in quickly. Yeah, it was a nice little bar, sports bar. Came here a few times back in the 90s. Grandma's Garden. Never ate there before. Jackie's Thai. Jackie's Thai has a lineup. The other places have nobody in line, and this place has a small lineup. So. So that's interesting. See these wooden columns here? There's more of them up here. And I guess not only is it artistic, but it'll prevent the flow of cars from coming through here, I guess, once they're done. They've got a new promenade here, I think that's new, with the steps, and it's going to come all the way through. Should be nice. At least it's going to be used as the same as it was before and not have a building there. It'll be kind of a throughway or a gateway into Prince's Island Park. Interesting. Nobody's given me shit for using my camera inside there. I don't see how they could. But I'm gonna walk around the other side and get to the park. I got a bottle of water and I'm gonna go sit down and listen to some music and soak in some sunshine. Here's a shot from this angle. I heard these people were paid, and I could be wrong, somebody said 800 grand a piece for their homes. Obviously people are still living there. I guess they have till June to get out maybe. And there's the patio for the garage, that bar. Some major changes. They have underground parking.